Pretty, all right, that's one of my favorite songs. I know we sing it a lot, but just think about the words. Mm-hmm. It's all just a hymn on turn to page 160. We'll sing both verses. You would stand to your feet. 160. What a day that will be.
Church this morning, and we pray that if there's something on your heart that's not supposed to be there, pray and get it off. Amen. Right. Sister Donna, good to see you. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you.
Amen.
We got a couple little girls back there, and it's good to see her, and we just rejoice with you that God is still in control. Amen.
Yes.
And we got some honeymooners here this morning. Amen. Y'all stand up, amen. We had okay, all right. Let's give them a hand, amen. Stand up, man. Good to see y'all. Y'all pray for them and pray that God would bless them a hundredfold, amen. And Mama, good to see you here, amen. And it's good to see you, and thank God for God's faithfulness, amen. And being with you through the death of your husband, amen. God is the comforter,
yes,
and he's the peace. Mary Lou, good to see you and your granddaughter, those that we haven't seen in a while. So it's just a joy to see everybody, amen. And if you're tuning in from Facebook Live, amen, let me say it's a joy to have you tuning in and being a part of our service. And you share this video, and we're just going to give God all the glory. Now, we're missing two special people today, our pastor and his wife are not here. She's actually in quarantine. She's going to go in and have surgery. I think it's on the 25th. And so they're going to basically be in quarantine before and after the surgery. So, and I know, bless Cindy's heart, I know she's been drove crazy by him. Amen. But look here, if you need your oil change, just drive on up to the shop. He's got plenty of time to change oil or change wiper blades or brake pads or whatever might need to be done. Amen. So we'll keep him busy in the shop. Amen. But it's such a joy to be able to be here. And I'm glad you're here, and most of all, we're glad God's here. And we miss our pastor. I miss him dearly. I missed y'all last week. Amen. I was preaching in Charity. It's good to see everybody's face. And ain't it good to be able to come together, God's people, and rejoice. Amen. Brother Larry said, before long, he'll be able to swing a softball bat. Amen. That shoulder slowly limbering up, but we just thank God for what he's doing in our midst. Amen. Michelle's got a video that we're going to play, and I'm going to have her to cue it up, and I hope it'll be a real blessing to you. Let me read a passage of scripture to you in Romans chapter 8 and verse 1. Romans chapter 8 and verse 1, and ponder on this while we're hearing the singing, the videos. It says, there is therefore now no condemnation to them which are in Christ Jesus, yes, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit.
Man,
amen.
Right.
God's good. Amen. Amen. I trust that this will be a blessing to you, Brother Roger. Okay. Michelle was it when I put her on the spot, just like that. Amen.
Sorry, it's got to warm up.
Sometimes, and you don't understand why, but it's just the way it is. This song is called Father Forgive Me.
I believe in your son.
Amen.
shore. Like a two-edged sword. Sometimes my mouth says some hateful words. But I know, yes I know, yes I know, I've been made new. Forgive me, Father, for I know.
It is to be able to give to the Lord. Amen. Thank God for that. Amen. All right. Let's, Brother Slats, would you open us up in prayer this morning?
Father, you're so good to us, Lord.
Yes, God.
You always are. Father, we thank you for what you do, Lord, and supplying our needs, Lord. I just thank you, Father,
yes,
for the time we have to give back to you. I pray, God, that you'll use it for your glory. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Be seated. Amen.
Back there, you don't have to worry.
Gonna sing this song last Sunday. God changed the plan, I love what Jesse brought.
Amen. Bless him. Bless him more.
I ain't gonna never get the choir off, y'all.
Thank you.
choir, appreciate the singers, appreciate the sound people and all of you, Michelle, everybody that works in the church, all of you that does for the Lord, amen.
Amen.
It don't go unnoticed. Christine gets up here and plays that piano, thank God she does, because you don't want to hear me on it. Mess your ears up. You won't be back the next Sunday. Thank God for Christine, amen.
Amen. Bless him, Lord.
I've never done this on before. I found myself last night talking about my daughter. She lost somebody that meant a lot to her. Girl with old wings, she was kind of like grandma to her. And I found myself having, you know, good daddy talk about, you know, when they pass on.
Yeah.
And just, you know, it's always hard. And with the kids, when you have to explain that to them and try to, you know, let them understand that that person's a lot better on the other side.
That, amen. That's exactly right.
That it's, you know, they're going somewhere where it's, there's not going to be no pain, no hurt, none of that. And I just want to go ahead and send this to her and dedicate this pearl to the pastor away.
Amen.
Actually, I've not done it before, so I hope you'll hang with me. Let's give it a try here.
Then I'll hug his neck when I get where I'm going. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. There's so much pain, so much darkness, and this world to stumble through. All these questions I can't answer, and so much what to do. But when we get well, we'll go on. Our Maker's grace, we'll stand forever in the light. He's amazing grace, and we get where we're going.
Means a lot to a lot of people. Her life always been about Jesus. First time I ever met her, I thought, what a portrait of grace. I'd like to be like her. But if she was here, she'd rebuke me and she'd say, you be like Jesus. I'll let you down, disappoint you. I'll leave you. He won't. But she loves him so. I've never seen anybody I don't believe in my life. Seen a lot of people that love him, but she's one of those that just loves him.
Amen.
She wakes up to him, she goes to bed with him, she walks with him every day. And she prays without ceasing. She's taught me a lot of things that she's preached to me and she never knew about it. Told me things a lot of times, Brother Gary, didn't want to hear but needed to hear, buddy. Miss Cindy, we all love you. We know God ain't done what you get.
Amen. Amen. That's right. Amen. Amen.
So this song's for you.
Amen. Amen. Bless you, Lord.
Down on the open sea. The anchor holds. Though the ship is battered, the anchor holds. Though the sails are torn, I have fallen on my knees as I face life's raging seas. The anchor holds in spite of the storms. I've had visions and I've had dreams. But the anchor holds, though the ship is battered, the anchor holds, though the sails are torn, I have fallen.
Praise the Lord. Amen. Turn your Bibles to Galatians chapter 6. Amen. And I'm going to read a portion of scripture there in Galatians chapter 6. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Thank you, Roger. Don't that shirt look good on Roger.
Amen. I
ain't used to seeing that cover on Roger. Amen.
You see me now.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. Appreciate the choir. Appreciate the good singing. And now the most important time. Amen.
Amen.
The Word of God. Amen.
Amen.
Thank God for His Word. Did you know that His Word is settled in heaven this morning?
Amen.
Amen. Did you know that men's trying to change it and they trying to come up with new ideas about God's Word, but His Word is settled in heaven today?
Yeah.
Amen. I'm so thankful for that. Amen.
Amen.
Galatians chapter 6, look with me in verse 7. The Word of God says, be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. For he that soweth to the flesh shall of the flesh reap corruption. But he that soweth to the Spirit shall of the Spirit reap life everlasting.
Yes.
And let us not be weary in well doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Pray with me. Father, in Jesus' name,
yes, in Jesus'
Father, we thank you
for
this opportunity we have to be able to come together, Lord.
Yes.
God, our desire right now
yes.
is to worship you in spirit
yes.
and truth.
God.
And Lord, as we come to your holy word today,
yes.
I pray, God, would you give us words of wisdom,
yes.
words of encouragement, yes. Lord. God, not only let us be hearers, but God, let us be doers
yes.
of your word.
Praise
Lord, do a work in this place you already have.
Yes. Yeah.
And Lord, we'll thank you and we'll praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. You can
Amen.
Be seated. Amen.
Praise
Hallelujah.
Yes.
He said in verse 7, be not deceived. God is not mocked.
Amen.
Oh, yeah. There's people talking about God. This, you know, it don't take long till you're in a crowd of people and you mention Jesus, about 3/4 of them or not, maybe all of them will scatter, won't they?
Yeah.
They don't want to hear this thing about Jesus and about God, amen? But let me tell you, friends, God will not be mocked, amen?
Right.
The Bible tells us in Philippians that every knee will bow
yep.
and every tongue will confess
amen.
That Jesus is Lord,
yes.
amen? How many of you know He's Lord?
Yes.
He's Lord.
Yes.
He's my Savior.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
He's the great I am. Amen. He's wonderful counselor,
yes.
mighty God,
yes.
Prince of Peace,
yes.
everlasting Father.
Yes.
He's the Holy One, hallelujah. He's the one that lives in my heart, hallelujah. He's the one that lives in you as a born-again believer, amen.
Yes.
Ain't that good?
That's
great. Boy, I tell you what, if that don't get you stirred up, you need salvation, amen.
Yeah.
Because greater is He that is in me than he that's in the world.
Amen.
I'm reminded of a scripture in 1 John. It's not Bart that I first loved God. Did you hear me? It's not that we first loved God,
right.
but that He first loved us.
Amen.
Ain't that good?
Yeah.
Right.
Woo! He first loved me, amen.
Yeah.
He first loved me. Now, I'm loving God. Yeah. I'm loving Jesus. But he says, be not deceived. God is not mocked. For whatsoever a man soweth, that shall he also reap. How many of you have planted a garden before? Okay? Seeds, amen. Thank God the Word of God, the seed was planted in my heart one day through the preaching of the gospel, and I received the Lord Jesus Christ. Now, the Word has sprung up in my heart, and now I've got to tell everybody, amen, the great things that God's done for me. Amen. Brother Alton reads that scripture, Psalms 40, every day, don't you, Alton? What does it say? Well, He's put us on a rock, amen. He's established our goings. Put a song in my heart, amen. And I can't even sing, amen. But I can sing a joyful song to the Lord, amen. Because let the redeemed of the Lord say so.
Amen.
That's why I like getting on the lawnmower or in the shower. I can sing, amen.
Amen.
Amen. But listen here. God will not be mocked. Amen. In other words, he won't be made fun of.
No, he won't.
He won't be scorned. Because let me say, friends, he's got the last say-so. Amen. And I'm so thankful that I'm on the winning side. Amen. Aren't you?
Amen.
I don't know about you, but I like to be on the winning team, don't you? I like it. It's fun, amen. You get to rejoice, you get to cut up and just have a good time, don't you? But when you lose, it's not too fun, is it? I'm going to tell you what. Those people that are mocking and scorning God, their day will come. And God will have the final say. So did you know there's two judgments in the Bible? And I want to talk to you about one briefly this morning. There's two judgments. There's one, it's called the Great White Throne Judgment. And that's for sinners. Did you know that you and I, as a believer, we will not be judged at that Great White Throne Judgment. But we will be judged at the judgment seat of Christ. Have you ever been judged? I was thinking about this. Mama, in the second grade, I was living in Concord before we moved here in 72 to Stanley County. But anyway, I was chosen in the second grade, Slats, to go uptown and paint a harvest scene on a window. And I had fun. I drawed hay bales and pumpkins and all kind of stuff. And then, Landon, they came around and they judged us. They judged how our painting was. And that was a privilege. Caleb, my youngest son, he was in a band. Samuel was too. And they used to go to competitions. And they was judged on how they performed. They were judged on how they marched and how they played. And bless your heart, sometimes they didn't even get a reward. I mean, they worked hard, but they didn't get a reward. And think about this, that one day, the Bible says that we're going to be judged. Boy, that's a sobering thought, man. Did you know that I can hide things from you and you can hide things from me? But let me say this. We cannot hide things from God. The things that were done in the darkness, they'll be brought out to the light. Listen to me, children. Listen this morning. Because the Bible says... Let me turn to it. The Bible says that we are going to appear before the judgment seat of Christ. Amen? So in other words, I'm going to be judged / this morning on how I preach this message for the Lord Jesus Christ. Did I do it for myself or did I do it for God? Amen? That's a sobering fact. But it says that we will all in 1 Corinthians 5, in verse 10, the Bible says, "For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, not to give an account of our salvation, because that was taken care of." Amen. When we asked Jesus, not that we were lost or we were saved. In other words, what I'm trying to say, but we will stand before a righteous judge that day. And we will give an account of our stewardship to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes, we will.
Yep. How faithful we was to Him.
That's right.
You know, I'm having to get this twice. When I studied it and now when I preach it. Y'all only having to get it one time. But I'm going to tell you what. It puts me in, it puts my mind and my spirit at odds. Because I will stand before Him. And did you know the Bible says, Bart, that we can have rewards. That we can be rewarded by the Lord Jesus Christ and by God Almighty. Amen. Ain't that wonderful? I don't know about you, Slats, but I want some trophies to lay down at the feet of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want some. I want some rewards. Did you know there's a reward for those that look for His appearing.
That's right.
There's a reward for those that win souls. Amen. That lead other people to Christ. There's a reward of faithfulness to Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes,
I don't know about you, but I want those.
Amen.
I want them.
Praise you, brother.
Think about standing before a holy and righteous judge that knows everything about us.
Yep.
He even knows the very hairs on our head, don't he? He knows that little sparrow that falls to the ground this morning. He knows that. God, have mercy.
Yeah.
Help me to live righteous before you. Amen.
Amen.
That's my prayer.
Yeah.
But the Bible says that, for we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that everyone may receive the things done in his body.
Yep.
According to that which he hath done, whether it be good or whether it be bad.
Yep.
In Romans 14 and 10, the last part of verse 10, it says, for we shall all stand before the judgment seat of Christ. For we must all stand before the judgment seat of Christ. It brings tears to my eyes because I know that I've not always been faithful to Him. But I'm so thankful, Mama, that repentance is there if we will ask.
Yes.
Read Psalms 51 today. When you go home, read Psalms 51. That's a prayer that David prayed. David sinned. He sinned before God. The Bible says David was a man after God's own heart. Let me say, if David was a man after God's own heart, that's probably more spiritual than me. But yet, David sinned.
Yep.
David committed adultery. Let me say this morning that none of us are above sin today.
That's right.
Can I hear you say amen?
Amen.
None of us are above sin.
That's right.
We're all sinners. And the Bible says we've all come short of the glory of God.
Right.
There is none righteous, no, not one. For all have sinned
right.
And come short of the glory of God. Now there's a difference in me and you as a believer because Jesus dwells within us.
Yeah.
And all those sins that we did before He got saved, He forgave us.
Yeah.
Ain't that good? He forgave us, hallelujah.
Yeah.
He threw them behind His back. He threw them into the depths of the sea to remember them no more.
Yeah.
The precious blood of Jesus, how powerful the precious blood of the Lamb is.
Thank you, Lord.
An old black heart. And the blood of Jesus washed my sins. He took that old stony heart out and He put a new heart within.
Yeah.
And guess what? That new heart thrives on Jesus.
Yeah.
Are you hungry after the things of God? Think about it. There's not a day goes by, Slash, that I don't think about Jesus.
Yes.
And I don't think about His Word. Why? Because that new heart is in me.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
That new heart is in me.
Glory to God.
Woo!
Yeah, brother.
Ain't that good?
Yeah.
It wants the things of God. Amen.
Yeah.
That's why when I open up God's Word, it's a love letter to me. That's God's love letter to me. And you know, I was reading in 2 Peter that this word, Slats, is not of any private interpretation, but it is for all men. Hallelujah.
Yes.
It don't matter what color you are.
Right.
Preach it, brother.
It don't matter male or female. Yeah. It don't matter your nationality. This word is for you.
Yes.
This word is not of some private interpretation.
Woo.
But let me tell you what holy men of God has ever been by the Holy Ghost. And being wrote this. They were led by the Holy Ghost. So you know what that means? God breathed this book. God breathed it. It's the best seller. Why do we neglect this so much? Why do we neglect it, brother? Because we walk after the flesh and not after the Spirit. You know, the Bible says that if we walk after the flesh, what would we do? We will mind the things of the flesh. But, thank God there's another part of that. It says that if we walk after the Spirit, we shall reap life everlasting. That's good, ain't it?
That's good stuff.
We must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that we will give an account of everything in our, that we've done in our body, whether it be good or bad. I want to take care of those things that are not righteous. I want to take care of them here. Let me tell you what. So that's 1 John 1:9.
Yes.
The Bible says that we have an advocate with the Father.
Yep.
And that's Jesus Christ. You know what? Listen. The Holy Spirit lives in us as a believer. The Holy Spirit directs our prayers to who? To Jesus.
Yes.
And Jesus is on the right hand of the Father. And the Bible says that He ever liveth to make intercessions for us.
Right.
Amen. And the Bible says that if we would confess our sins,
yeah,
child of God,
yeah,
I'm talking about us,
yeah,
because little John said, he said, if you say you have no sin, you deceive yourself and the truth is not in you.
That's right.
But he says, look, if we sin, let's don't strive to sin. We want to strive to be perfect and be like Christ.
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with that. But he said, but if we sin, he said, if we confess our sins, that he's what?
He is faithful.
I'll say it again.
He's faithful.
He's faithful. And he's just to forgive us of our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. So that means if I do mess up, if I do stumble, if I do fall, and I will, that he's faithful just to forgive me of my sins,
yes,
and to cleanse me from all unrighteousness.
Yes.
Ain't it good when you're,
yes,
forgiven?
Amen.
Ain't it good?
Yes, thank you, Lord.
When you and your wife, y'all had a spat. Ain't it good when you make up?
Yeah.
Now, you know what I'm talking about.
Yeah. Yeah.
Ain't it good when you make up? Amen.
Yeah.
Make up with Jesus. Amen.
Yeah.
Get it right with Jesus.
Oh,
amen.
Lord.
Get it right with Him.
Yeah.
And feel the Holy Ghost roll, amen.
Amen.
Greater is He that is in me than he that is in the world.
That's right. Glory to God.
For the Bible says in Romans 14:10, the last part, for we shall stand before the judgment seat of Christ. We're going to keep that appointment. I lined up yesterday to get my oil changed. I didn't have an appointment, and it was 8 cars. You know what I did? I didn't get my oil changed. Because I didn't want to wait that long. I'm going to tell you what. Standing before Jesus, we're going to keep that appointment.
Yeah.
We're going to keep that appointment. We won't get out of that. Let me say this morning, God loves you. He loves me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
He wants to see you prosper in the things of God. God is good. Amen.
Yes, all the time.
How is it with you and God today? The Bible says there's another judgment, and that's the great white throne judgment. And that's those that think, well, I'm not going to bow down here. I'm not going to confess to God. This day you will.
Yep.
This appointment you will.
Yep.
Because the Bible says that you will be judged. And after you're judged, the Bible says you'll be cast into a lake of fire that burneth with fire and brimstone.
Yep. Yep.
And you'll just burn up and it'll be over. Nope.
Yep.
He said everlasting to everlasting.
Right.
The fire is bad. The darkness is bad. But think about it, being separated,
yes,
from a holy and righteous God, that's even worse.
Yes, it is.
Right.
I don't know about you, but I love the things of God.
That's right.
I love to meet down here and pray. I love to get around you and talk about Jesus.
Amen.
I love that. Landon, I love when you was up here teaching this morning. I love that. I love the things of God. Do you love the things of God? If you don't, check up. You may not have ever been saved, amen. Because let me tell you what, the Bible says when you get saved, you know what? That you're a new creature.
Yes.
You're a new creature in Christ Jesus. It says all things will pass away.
Yeah.
Behold, all things become you.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
I don't have time to read it, but 2 Timothy or 2 Peter says in the last days, the mockers, scoffers. Let me tell you what. Said in 2 Peter chapter 2, God spared not the old world, but he destroyed the old world, save Noah and his family. Let me say, friends, you can mark it down. You can mark it down. God kept his word then, and he's going to keep his word now. Amen. To the end. If God spared not the old world, look here. There's an ark today, and it's the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yep.
You know more. Enter into the ark of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Yes.
And you can be saved.
Amen. Amen. Preach it, brother.
Could you imagine preaching 120 years and the only people got saved was your family? Mm-hmm. Thank God he had enough testimony that he was able to lead his family to Jesus.
Yeah.
But let me tell you what, friends, one day God's going to shut the door.
Yes,
and when God shuts the door, it's over. Because what God shuts, no man will open. No man will open. Are you born again? Don't play church, friends. Do not play church. Because your soul is weighed in the balance this morning. Your soul is weighed in the balance. Lose your pride and come and fall on your knees and give your heart to Jesus and enter into the ark of safety, the Lord Jesus Christ. Child of God, be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God for your life. Let me say, friends, the Bible says in 2 Peter that a Christian can go so far they can forget they've ever been purged from their old sins. I don't know about you, but I don't want to be there. I don't want a whooping. I don't like whoopings. I ran with my hand behind my behind because I didn't like whoopings. And you surely don't like one from God, amen.
No.
You know what I'm talking about. Y'all ran like that too.
Yeah.
Y'all ran. Y'all know exactly what I'm talking about. Oh, you ran. Let me tell you what, friends. I don't want a whooping from God. I want to live in the Spirit. You know, I'm reminded, it's in the 8th chapter also, that it says that our spirit bear witness that we are the sons of God.
Amen.
Yeah, amen, brother.
Thank God the witness lives in me.
Yeah.
And in you as a child of God, that we know that we're saved in me. We were talking about it yesterday, Brother Wayne, 1 John 5:13. These things have I written that you might know. No, that ain't what it says. It said that you may know that you have eternal life. I know, mama, that I'm saved. I know I'm going to heaven. Hallelujah. You've got to know that. It ain't no hope so or maybe so. I know, hallelujah, that I'm saved. And I'm sealed to the day of redemption. By things I did know, by things that Christ did. By what Jesus did. The finished works at Calvary.
Yeah.
He took my hell. He took my punishment for me and for you.
Yeah.
Ain't that good?
Yep.
For we must all appear before the judgment seat of Christ.
That's right.
Woo.
Yes, Lord God.
Lord, come quickly.
Yes.
Yeah.
Stand with me today. Amen. Stand with me. Christine will come and play something.
Thank you.
I'm glad the Holy Spirit preached this morning because I didn't really have it together, amen. But I'm glad God did. God knew and God wanted to see what was said this morning. So this morning now, this is your part of the service. Did God speak to you? Did God through the Holy Spirit speak to your heart this morning? Then let me say that you need to respond to God's word. Every head bowed, every eye closed. Christina's going to play. listen to the call of God and respond to Him. Strive to have rewards to lay at the feet of Jesus. Amen. Appreciate you being here this morning. Amen. Thank you for the songs. Thank you for just being here. Thank you for the choir, Roger. Good. Amen. And please tell people about Jesus this week. Amen. Michelle.
We have the prayer cards over up front. If you have a prayer request, fill out the card, put it in the box. Prayer warriors will pray over those on Wednesday nights. We have the missions jar up front. If you could help support our 9 missionaries by putting change, bills, whatever in that jar, that goes to them. And then tonight's service, I think Slats will be sending that out through text message, so look for that.
Yeah, I don't want to take away from anything, but Let me say this. There's somebody here this morning. God's calling you. I feel it. Gary feels it. Flats feels it. A lot of you feel it. But let me just say this. We could all testify about our past. I was a person that ran from God for a long time. And I tried to fill the gap with everything. Music, partying, drugs, alcohol, you name it. I even bounced and done all kinds of stuff. It was just crazy, but took martial arts. I thought that would help, you know. But anyway, long story short, here's the thing about it. Is Jesus was calling me through people that were put in my pathway. I wouldn't go to church, okay? You've got an opportunity here to hear the Word of God preached every Sunday. Amen. And God is calling you. One night at Pfeiffer College Chapel, I had cleaned up my entire life. I quit drinking. I quit doing drugs. I quit going to parties. I started drinking tab. I don't know where some of you know that. So no, it was a drink you drank back then. It was just a diet drink. But anyway, Landon, I still didn't have any peace. And I quit cussing. I did everything I could. But one night at Firefield College Chapel, God called me there. It was almost 1 o'clock in the morning. And I was going to go get me a hit because I tried to clean up. I wanted some peace, and I thought maybe that would help. So all I had to do was go to the Washington dorm at Pfeiffer College and throw a pebble up on a certain window, and Judy would have came, and she'd have let me in, and we took a hit. It's called a bomb, okay? So I started across there, Dale, from the other side of the road, started across the road there, was just stepping down, and the chapel was right over there, and it was glowing, and Jesus was calling me. Come unto me. Come unto me. That's all I could hear.
Yes.
And I'm going to tell you something. I didn't cry. I was tough. I tried to be tough. I had an image to maintain. Okay? I was an idiot, but like there was a few people that was afraid of me. I don't know why, because I could easily be whooped. But anyway, but there I was. I thought the chapel won't be open. Those doors will be closed this time of night. It was open. And the street lights were shining across the pews. And I remembered what my mama told me. She told me, Jesus loves me.
Amen. Bless you.
She lived Jesus in front of me. She never condemned me. I'd come to her house. Sometimes I couldn't find my house coming from a party. And I'd make it to my mama's house. Yes. And that precious little thing, say, are you all right? And she knew I was drunk. She didn't say, sorry, dog, you could come to my house like this again. I won't ever come back. And she'd get up the next morning and fix me a meal. And she'd pray, she'd say, God, I know one day, and I kept my eyes open, Dale, looking at her. Said, one day, God, you're going to save my son.
Amen.
And I, in my heart, I wanted that. I said, Mom, I wanted that, but you know, my pride. But there was Jesus that night at that Firefield College Chapel. I went through those doors, and I came halfway down that aisle. And I hit my knees.
Amen.
And I said, God, I'm the worst thing that's ever been born. You know everything I've done. I can't hide nothing from you. I'm the biggest sinner in Stanley County. I said, but I'm lost. And I faced death. I took knives and guns off of people and broke up fights. I could have been killed so many times. Fast cars, you name it. And I bowed my knee to a precious Savior
that
gave himself for me.
Yes.
He took all my sins upon him.
Yes.
That's what my mama told me. She said, he's done away with your sins. You just go to him.
Thank you.
He's your Savior. Brother Jody, I accept you my Savior. I said, I don't want to go to hell.
Amen.
Save me, Lord, and he saved. I've been saved ever since. You won't ever get unsaved. That's I'm going to tell you something. If you're here and you're struggling with that, maybe you got some things in your life. You say, well, you know what? I don't think God loves me, and I'm just not ready. I'm going to tell you something. Larry, I believe that was the last time God was going to call me.
My.
And I came to his call. But it was the sweetest voice I ever heard.
Amen.
And I'll tell you something. Jesus just picked me up in his arms. And I went down the road last night. I cried. I said, Lord, you know me now, don't you? Yes, I know you.
Amen. Hallelujah.
So don't miss your appointment with Jesus. Amen. Don't be ashamed to come to him. Amen. I just want to tell you how I was. You'd be like an angel compared to the way I was. Don't miss him.
Thank you, brother.
Thank you, brother. Lord, we love you. Father, thank you so much for being so good to us, Lord. Lord, thank you for the songs that were sung today. Thank you for the fellowship, Lord. I pray, God, Lord, we'll continue to love each other. That's what you called us to do, Lord, and to encourage each other, to lift each other up. Father, thank you for your word. Oh, your word's powerful. Sharper than any two-edged sword. Pierces our hearts. Your word will never let us down. And we're so thankful. I pray, God, you'll be with us, Lord. Each and every one of us as we leave this building, that we'll take Jesus to the world. In his name we pray. Amen. Amen.